Hello everybody, today we're going to be talking about SPF. What is SPF, why you need to use it, when you need to use it, who should be using it, and all the jargon that comes with it. So this is long, there's a lot to go through, so we're just going to get on with it. So let's talk about sunscreen and SPF. What is it? So sunscreen is usually, it's a cosmetic product that protects you from the sun, as we know, that usually comes in like a creamy form, like a moisturizer kind of feeling kind of form. And this protects our skin from solar radiation, so UVB and UVA rays. So UVA rays can penetrate deep into our skin, so deep into the dermis, which is the skin's thickest layer. So unprotected exposure to UVA rays can cause our skin to age quicker. It makes it wrinkle, it gets rid of the elasticity. It kind of causes everything we link with the appearance of aging. Whereas UVB rays are the ones that burn us. They're the ones that can cause skin cancer. So everyone goes on about anti-aging products, but the best anti-aging product you can ever have is a sunscreen. So sun damage is to blame for around 80% of the appearance and everything we link to the appearance of aging. As I mentioned, fine lines, wrinkles, dark spots. So protecting your skin against these UVA rays and the sun will help us age a bit more gracefully. And obviously skin cancer. We want to be protected from skin cancer, especially if you enjoy the sun and you spend a lot of time in the sun and you're sunbathing. The UVB rays is, you know, really what you want to be protected from. So who needs it? This is a bit of a funny one because a lot of people are like, oh, you know, I got dark skin, I'm naturally tanned, I got black skin, I don't need to wear SPF. This is incorrect. All this means is that the darker your skin, the lower the factor of SPF you can wear. So whilst darker skin tones are higher in the pigmentation melanin, which is, you know, what we get when we tan, it does provide a little bit of protection against sun damage, more than your, you know, your Caucasian friends. But it's still important to wear a broad spectrum SPF, so an SPF that protects you from UVA and UVB rays. Dark skin can still get burned and still obviously can get damaged and age quicker. Everyone can. So the darker your skin, the lower the SPF you can use, but still use it. Now, when should we use SPF? Pretty much all the time. It's obvious that it needs to be used in summer. I think everybody just splashes it on in summer. But a lot of people think that just because it's winter and there's clouds out that we don't need to wear it. That is completely wrong. Whilst the UVB rays, so the rays that burn us, aren't, you know, always there, you know, they're not the most prominent in winter, UVA rays can still get through. So if anti-aging is a big, is a big concern for you, definitely wear sunscreen during winter. UVB rays are still there, they're just not that prominent. So if you do find a good SPF that you like, a broad spectrum one, just wear it all the time. Make it part of your skincare routine. Then obviously in winter you can cover up your body a bit more, all that kind of stuff. Now we know there's a lot of products up there from makeup to moisturizer with an SPF built in. Usually it's an SPF 15. It's always, nah. I prefer wearing a separate SPF. And a lot of dermatologists always recommend wearing a separate SPF to what's in your cosmetics, other cosmetics. Because basically a lot of people just don't use the amount that we're supposed to use. And that's especially in the summer. You should not be using a 2-in-1 in the summer. You should be using separate moisturizer than an SPF. Because as I mentioned, we just don't use enough. That little bit of sunscreen that's in your moisturizer isn't going to be enough to give you enough coverage. But these 2-in-1 style cosmetics should be absolutely fine during the winter. So that being said, how much SPF should we actually be using on our face and our neck? So it's recommended a full teaspoon, and then I just wear like a spritzy one on my body during the winter, during the summer, then just cover up in the winter. So what is SPF? I've been mixing up the words sunscreen and SPF here because a lot of people refer to sunscreen as SPF, but SPF actually stands for sun protection factor. Yeah? Yeah. So it's a measure of how well the sunscreen is going to protect your skin from the UVB rays. Again, the rays that cause burns, skin cancer, skin damage in general. So this is where it does get a little bit confusing, so bear with me. Get a notepad. You tend to see SPF 15, 30, and 50. I feel like they're the most popular. And a lot of people believe the higher the number, the more protection you're getting. So for example, a lot of people believe that an SPF 15 is half of an SPF 30. So with an SPF 30, you're getting double the protection you would get if you were wearing a factor 15. Still with me? However, SPF 15 roughly gives you about 93% protection, whereas 100 SPF, you can get that, gives you 99% protection. So there's not a huge difference in between. So dermatologists always kind of say SPF 30 is a good all-round factor for everyone to use. There's no point really in using an SPF 100. It's ridiculous. You can't get 100% protection from the sun, ever. So as mentioned, the SPF 15, 30, 50 is a measurement of the protection that your the sunscreen will give you from sun damage against the UVB rays, and how long you can stay out in the sun before you need to reapply your sunscreen, and how long it's gonna protect you for. So again, it's gonna get difficult. Maths is not my strong point. So for example, if you go out in the sun and you sunbathe and your skin starts to burn after 10 minutes, and you wear a factor 30, SPF 30, what the SPF 30 allows you to do is stay out in the sun 30 times longer than you usually would without an SPF. So then SPF 15 will allow you to stay out 15 times longer than you usually would do before you burn. So if it takes 10 minutes for your skin to burn and you put on an SPF 15, then you'll be able to stay out for 150 minutes before you need to reapply. And that's how long it protects you for. Got it? I'm really bad at explaining stuff. For me personally, I don't hang out in the sun. I just don't enjoy it. I don't like summer. So I'll put on an SPF face and neck in the morning, spray some on my arms, and then the rest of my body is usually covered up. Then I'll reapply it halfway through the day, just because I'm walking around. I'm always inside. I don't like being out in the sun. So I apply roughly twice a day, and the majority of myself is covered up or I'm inside away from a window. So which kind of sunscreen is best for you? There are two main sunscreens. So we have mineral sunscreen and chemical sunscreen. When I first heard about these years ago, I thought mineral was like natural and chemical wasn't. That's far from the case. So chemical sunscreen will sink into your skin and has active ingredients that are designed to absorb UV rays and not let it go deeper into your skin. Mineral sunscreen sits on top of your skin and completely just blocks everything, you know, it's like it can't get through. These contain titanium dioxide and zinc oxide. These are the ones that go on very white. They got a very heavy white cast to them. So as I mentioned, both protect from the sun, but what ones are best for you? So I have a mineral sunscreen. This is from Etude House. So mineral sunscreen doesn't sink into the skin as I mentioned, so it is less likely to irritate your skin. So if you are spot prone or you just have sensitive skin, this may be the better one for you. It also won't clog pores as well, which is a plus. So good for congested skin, oily skin, I guess, as well. However, again, mineral sunscreens have a very white cast, as you can see here. It takes some time to settle into your skin. But in my opinion, I just give it like 20, 30 minutes, and the cast is pretty much gone and settles into your skin quite nicely. If you do like a bit of like a lighter glow to your skin, it's good for cosmetic reasons as well. Also, because this just acts as a cover for your skin, however, you do need to make sure you're covered. You know, it doesn't spread as easily, so it's only gonna protect your skin from what you've covered with the product. So you need to make sure you're getting a good even spread. I'm actually wearing a mineral one now. It's boiling hot in here. You can see my skin has a bit of a whiter cast to it, and it doesn't act too well with sweat, I've discovered. So I might have like a few white bits in the corner here or in my eyelids as well. It's not the most like flattering if you're gonna go out and be sweaty or in a hot room with your windows shut, for example. So I have a chemical one here, and this is a COSRX. And you'll need less product from a chemical sunscreen as it spreads thinner to cover the surface area of your skin. So these are like, in my opinion, a very nice, watery, creamy moisturizer. I do not use a moisturizer when I'm using a chemical sunscreen. In fact, any sunscreen. And they usually do have like moisturizing factors put in them. So they are the nicer kind of option, in my opinion. And they're better for dry and dehydrated skin as well. It took me a while to find an SPF that worked for me, so you do have to experiment and try around, test like a few. I have sensitive, irritable skin, but this chemical sunscreen seems to work absolutely fine for me. But they come from everything from gels to creams to sticks, so that you can find something that's good for you. Either way though, try and find a broad spectrum SPF sunscreen, that can protect you from UVA and UVB rays. This is why I kind of like the Asian brand sunscreens, because they've got SPF and sunscreen down. They've got it perfect. Sunscreen should always be the final step in your skincare routine. So whether you skip moisturizer or apply it, it's always the last step. If you're like me and have oily skin, you may find that you don't need to use a moisturizer, the sunscreen will be enough. Once you put on your SPF, then makeup can be applied over that if you wear makeup. But what about beards? I know, like, it is a little bit confusing. As you can see here, this is why I use a chemical sunscreen mainly, because it's a bit more liquidy and kind of can be massaged gently into the skin under the beard without leaving whiteness in your facial hair. But there's not really much of an option here. I mean, your beard is going to provide a little bit of coverage, but if it's like little stubble like mine, just spread it over, massage in, and try and stay out of the sun. So here's a few other bits of jargon, especially with the SPFs I recommend and that I like. They always have a PA rating, so a PA plus or a PA plus plus. What does this mean? This is an Asian thing. You don't really see it in Western culture. It's a protection grade of UVA. So the rays that age you and give you dark spots, all that kind of stuff. So the PA rating, to put it very, very simply, gives you a rough estimate of how long you can stay in the sun before you start to tan. And that, you know, tanning comes along with dehydrated skin, wrinkles, all that kind of stuff. But so yeah, saying that, you can still tan when you're wearing SPF. A lot of my friends think they don't wear SPF because they're like, oh, but I want a tan. You will get a tan, just, you know, very slowly, but you're gonna get one still. So yeah, the PA++ rating is good if you have dark spots, if you get, I use PA++ because if I have a dark spot on my face, I don't want that getting darker. So using a SPF, a sunscreen with a high PA++ rating gives you a good protection so that doesn't get worse. And I want to look young for a long time, so it's important. Me personally, when it comes to sunscreen, I wear it every day. If it's hot, I'll just use it instead of a moisturizer. If it's cold, I'll use a gel moisturizer, then an SPF. If my body is exposed, I don't like to go out in the sun, as I mentioned. I use like a spray SPF because they're really easy to use. You just spray them on every so often. And then you end up applying regularly as well because it is so easy to apply. So yeah, I don't like being hot. I avoid the sun. But you know, if you do like the sun, just make sure you're reapplying SPF. Reapply, reapply, reapply. Sit in the shade when you can. Sit inside when you can. Just use SPF. Is really important, whether it's for health reasons or purely vanity, it's important for both. Hide from the sun. No, don't do that. I'm like a vampire, I just want winter to come. But I hope that explains some stuff. Leave your comments down below and any questions, because I do get a bit tongue-tied. I had to write this all out because I needed a structure to talk, otherwise I would have just been everywhere. But yeah, leave your questions down below. I hope that helped. I'll obviously link the products that I use down below. You guys are gonna ask me for suggestions for an SPF, but I can't really recommend ones. You just have to discover that for yourself, because what works for me is very unlikely to work for you. So it's the same for everyone. But yes, that is it from me now, guys. I will see you next time.